Hello and welcome everyone. There's just one more participant left, so until she joins, we'll just have an interaction, a little chat. And first of all, I'd like to thank you all very much for guiding me and supporting me, and because of all of you, Creative Kalakar has successfully completed a year from starting just a couple of weeks back. The Creative Kalakar completed its 1 year after starting, and that's because of all of you for supporting us, helping us, and being a part of it. Thank you so much, everyone. Okay, so
you are following your passion, and it's very important that it's a very gutsy task when you follow your passion, you know. So I am really happy and really proud of you, Ayushi, the way that you've been nurtured and you molded yourself in the creative field. And I see that now you are a teacher yourself, so I hope that you have more creativities bring on to your canvas, and you have all the success in the world, and you become a dynamic entrepreneur and be very successful. I would like to see the exhibition first, and then, you know, have a chat with all the participants here.
Thank you so much, ma'am. So until Ananya joins, our first participants joins, we'll just start with the exhibition and then continue further. So here I present to you all of your work.
Yes,
Ayush.
Okay. Yes.
Okay, great. So here I am just a welcome to all of you. Welcome to your exhibition. First up, we have Ananya's work. So until she joins, we'll just continue with the next participant. So Trisha, the wall is all yours and the stage is all yours.
Ule, you can introduce yourself, Trisha.
Hi, I'm Trisha Hegde. I'm in standard 5th. I live in Thane. Thank you, ma'am, for teaching us so nicely the drawings, and also I have my drawings are really improved. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you so much, Trisha. But could you just explain just one or two drawings for the audience? Just a few drawings if you like.
Yes, I made some food rakhis. One, I made a space drawing. Then I made Ganpati mandala. Also, I made one. Then one lotus craft, and then one string painting.
Great, Trisha. Great. Thank you so much. Next up, we have Purvi. Yes, Purvi, the stage is all yours.
Hello, myself. My name is Purvi Vikas Repale. I am 9 years old. And when I joined this drawing classes, I had a fun and enjoyment. So I thought, in this fun and enjoyment, I can draw any type of drawings. Thank you. The first is my favorite drawing, scenery. Second is a lotus, a paper. It's a made from paper. And the third is a butterfly. And the fourth is the space scenery. And the fifth was the mandala. Sixth was a mandala only. And the last one was the Ganesha. Thank you.
Explain how you get.
Great, Murthy. Can you just share your experience being in being a part of the Creative Kalakar? It's okay, dear. No problem. So, do you just enjoy being in drawing classes with us?
Yes.
Okay, great, great. So, Ananya, yeah. So, we'll start again with Ananya's wall. Ananya, here it is. You can go ahead. The stage is all yours. Yes, Ananya.
The first drawing that I've made is Madhubani, and then and I have made the drawing with only colors and sketch pens. Colors and sketch pen. I got it from Google. I got the picture from Google and I just copied it down. The second drawing which I have made is Varli art. And in the Varli art also I've used only sketch pins, and I have learned it from ICVP only in the Varli art class. The third drawing is mandala, which I made from the I use the highlighters, the sketch pins, the color pins, and protector. I got the designs from Google. I mixed up some designs and I made a particular one, and I used it in the mandala. These are the three mandalas. Then I have made the Zentangle art, which I also learned from IUCBD. And in the Zentangle, you get a picture, and then you have to create a picture with the object. So the art topic was leaf. So we created leaf with certain objects, geometry objects. And the other one I have made is a sketch, which it's a handmade drawing. I made it only a few days ago. I used shading in that, and that was a memory drawing of a person standing at the window and staring at the clouds with their eyes closed and feeling the blossom. Actually, what all I have learned from ICP and mandala is also very relaxing, and all the drawings which I have learned are very like nice and very pleasing, so I like it a lot for the reason.
Thank you so much, Ananya. Thank you. Okay, next up we have Dia. So this is Dia's wall. Over to you, Dia.
Yes, thank you, Ayushi ma'am. Hello everyone. So first of all, I'm going to introduce myself. My name is Dia Cheda, and mandala is one of my passions. When I do this type of art, I really feel relaxed, and this is the best exercise for a brain too. So mandala is an integrated structure of a unifying center. So now I will be speaking two words for my artworks. So the first one you all can see is the adorable lady. A mandala art done onto sari of makes a woman even more beautiful and attractive. And this is one of my favorite drawings. Then next is Lady with Dandiya. So a garba is a conversation between a body and a soul. Here the mandala art done in the background is really mesmerizing the beauty of the lady. The third one is Golden Buddha. Here the peace comes from within. Do not seek in without. And after giving a look at this mandala art with Golden Buddha, we feel like meditating. So mind is everything, what you think, and you become. Then the next one is Ma Durga. Color is the power which directly influences the soul, and Ma Durga represents the woman power and symbolizes the divine forces known as divine Shakti. The next is Ma Black Buddha. So here for me, Buddha represents wisdom, sanity, and peace. And there the mandala art is really enhancing the Buddha. Then is abstract circles. Here, little by little, day by day, what is meant for you all will definitely find its way. So this is one of my another abstract mandala. The next is cool bird. The nectar of the life is sweet only when shared with others. Here I have used the combination of black and green, which is really attracting the cool bird. Then is another abstractive mandala. You never know what you can do until you try, and very few try unless they have to. This is my first try for mandala art, and henceforth it became my passion. So when I do this art, I really enjoy it, and it needs lots of concentration and patience too. So here I end with the introduction, and I used to do mandala art, and one day when I saw a live video of Ayushi Ma'am's live video on YouTube, so I shared. So we both got connected, and I shared all my artworks to her, and she has a great knowledge of art, and I really thank her for giving me this wonderful opportunity to showcase all my artworks here. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Diya. The artworks are really great, and I really appreciate that you shared after seeing the live video. You shared your works with me, even I was so happy seeing all your works. Thank you so much. Next, we have Swara. She is one of the youngest member of our Creative Kalakar family, and she's been there with us from the start. So I could really say that her drawing has really improved in these times. So we'll hear it from her only, her experience. Swara?
My name is Swara Sagar. I'm 7 years old. The first painting is the night scenery. The second painting is abstract painting of a tree. The third painting is the fourth painting is the fourth painting is done by my own of a peacock. The fifth painting is from a girl. The sixth painting is a tree. I have used this smudging technique. This painting is a night scenery of the sunset night scenery. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Swara. I would just like to add on that all these paintings that you see on Swara's wall are done virtually. Like when we started with our virtual classes, these are the drawings she has made. These are none there are paintings that she has beautifully done when we were offline, but these she has done it by her own when we started it virtually. So I can really say that she has improved a lot with us. Thank you so much, Swara. Next up, we have Kuber. Kuber, you're there? Okay, Kuber's mic is not working, I guess. So Kuber is my younger brother, but I really haven't, I just teach him like a teacher and not as a brother. So these are his drawings that he has made during this lockdown period. And over a few years that he started drawing, these are some of his drawings. These are the recent ones that he has done. The Ganesha, the parrot, and a geometric drawing. So next up we have Vaishali ma'am. So this is her wall one.
Yeah, hello Ayushi. Myself, Dr. Vaishali, I'm not doctorate in medical, but I'm a doctorate from chemical engineering. And, I think so 25 years from my birth, I have spent in studies. So lot of achievements. So thank you, Ayushi. Means this lockdown, you discovered me that I have an art. So I'm very happy with doing this. So I'll just go one by one, and then I'll express about the creative kalakar times. So first drawing, you can see this I have drawn when Ayushi taught me. First we did a mandala, and then I just came across one drawing on the internet, and then I just drawn these. I thought it is somewhat similar like mandala, so I drawn this beautiful lady. Then next drawing is a dot mandala. That is again Ayushi taught us about this was wonderful experience. Mandala, dot mandala, and mandala. It's such a piece. Really, ask me, means in this lockdown period, the people are frustrated sitting at home, but really I have enjoyed with Ayushi. It's like I have learned so many drawings, so many arts you can come across as the wall goes. And the next is again half mandala along with the Ganesha. So whenever there is a festival coming, I start drawing, when there is a Ganesha. So I did this half mandala along with some balancing the negative and the positive part. Next is a Kalamkari. So this is also, my favorite art, what the Ayushi taught me. We had a 2 days workshop on the Kalamkari. And this is a really beautiful art, which we generally see from the Madhya Pradesh. Generally, we know that these are the saris, Kalamkari saris. We know very, very well known about Kalamkari saris. So I was having a Kalamkari sari, but I was not able to know that how it is drawn. But now along with this, I've done a lot of, but yet not completed. I'll share a letter to the Ayushi. Next is again the mandala. So this is, I also have done with the Ayushi. Ayushi, can you go to the next wall?
Yeah.
So the next is Madhubani. This is also I have done with the Ayushi. So Madhubani also, along with Madhubani, I have this is the one of the painting which was the project. This was I have done with Ayushi, and then I have done a lot of projects, but I'll submit that later. Again, the next is bone painting, which is also the beautiful art, which is a tribal art from the Madhya Pradesh, which is, the beautiful arts where the number of different types of animals and birds with different effects on their body and the motifs are done. So I have really enjoyed this, drawing the animals, because I've never ever drawn the science diagrams, except the science diagrams I have not drawn any figures as such. So this lockdown gave me a chance, and Ayushi taught me. Thank you, Ayushi, again. The next is this is another art, which is Surya art. So this is also again I've done with the Ayushi workshop. Next is again small mandala type, but it is not exactly half mandala, but it is somewhat I tried to draw some query type of design with the motifs. Again, next is mandala, that is half mandala. You can go to next, Ayushi. Okay. Then we have a Kavi art. That is the art, this elephant is from the Kavi art. This Kavi art, which is a special art from the Goa, and some coastal areas where in a Karnataka, we can see such type of the arts. These type of the arts are generally seen on the temples. And during workshop, this Ayushi has, she used to share different stories behind it. And that's why I remember that why this art is, and it is beautiful. Means drawing elephant is, the beyond my, but I did it. So I'm really very happy. My soul is very happy that I have done a lot of arts with him. The next is a Krishna. This I have just drawn with the, I was just wanted to draw some with the, you know, oil chalks. So this is, I've just done when there was a Gopal Kala, this festival was there. So I've inspired with the Krishna and I've done this as well as the next drawing. This is a Bal Krishna. Next is Bal Krishna. And next we have the art, which is a Pichwai art. This workshop also I have done with Ayushi, which is a special art. And I think so this art is around beyond 400 years old art from the Rajasthan. This depicts or tells the stories about the Lord Krishna's life. So the cow and a lotus, we all know that Krishna is associated with all these factors. So this I have done it. Even I have learned some drawing the small butti type of design along it. Next is again the Gond art. This design is actually made for the the sleeping bird which is on the wall. So this is again beautifully I have enjoyed this art. Next is again the Saurya art. This art is from the Saurya tribes and this is from Odisha. And in this type of the paintings, the horse is, you know, their special type of, or the very famous painting from the Saurya art is the horse. So that I have done in the next drawing. Ayushi, can you go to the next?
This is the last one.
Yeah. Thank you so much, Ayushi. I'll say the few words. As I said, that the people have frustrated in the lockdown. They have, the bored in the lockdown, but working 12 hours with the office continuously online, I was just waiting 7 o'clock that I'll start the creative workshop with you. I really liked it. I'm waiting for your next calendar. I want that you should do some workshops on the, the out of India arts, especially in case of Egypt, Egyptian arts or some African arts. And really, thank you so much. You discovered me, this gave me peace. And, the mandala is such a calm. Means after 12 hours pressure of the office, working means doing the workshop with you from 7 to 8 to 9:30, I have managed and I have done it. Means I just came to know what is the capacity I have. Means working home and taking care of all house work as well as the office and workshops. I was really happy. Thank you so much for the, this your time and your art. You are genius. Please keep on doing workshops like this for us. Like, working ladies, it is very difficult to, to capture or to nourish their hobbies. But thank you so much. Keep on doing workshops. Thank you.
Thank you so much for the very wonderful words, ma'am. Thank you so much. And we were really, I was really happy for, even taking workshops for you, because you were such a, your smile and your attitude always, helped me, take the workshops very comfortably. Thank you so much. And I'll definitely come up with a new calendar. Thank you.
Thank you, Ayushu. Thank you.
Next up, we have Rashmi ma'am's wall. Rashmi ma'am, due to some personal reasons, she could not attend the exhibition today. So these are her works that she did with us. The Gond Madhubani paintings, Zentangle mandalas, and Gond again. And these are some of the projects that she has done after she learned from me. So these are some extra mandalas and Madhubani. She has made a very beautiful Madhubani Radha Krishna here after learning Madhubani art from me. So next up we have Sunita ma'am.
Hi everyone, I'm Sunita Hegde. I'm working into an organization where food, pharmaceutical and cosmetic testings are carried out. So my job profile, keeps me on my wheel. So I hardly get any time to do such type of activities because of my dual responsibilities at home and office. So during this lockdown, since we were asked to do work from home, I thought that I should take up some of the activities. And then through one of my friend, I found Ayushi. And then I thought, let me just take out some time during the weekends and then learn the forms. Because I used to just scribble on and off whenever I used to get time, but was not aware about the art forms or the science behind it or the art behind it, to be precise. So then I have learned mandala, dot mandala, and Gond the painting through Ayushi. And Ayushi has all those skills to keep you engaged all the while. So I attended her one of the class, one of the batch, and then I decided that I should ask my daughter also to participate so that she keeps herself busy for 2 hours a day and away from the mobiles. So I mean, she does attend the classes from mobiles, but then she is busy with doing some sort of work. So we both of us are enjoying a lot learning through Ayushi. And to be honest, whenever I attend the art forms or the online classes, my daughter would be just, you know, sitting beside me or learning how she is teaching all the art forms, even to the elder crowd. So the mandala, what she has done, you must have seen on her wall, was not taught by Ayushi directly through her. But then she used to just see my art work lying on the table, and then she picked it up and she did it on her own. So that's how kids learn from you. And thank you, Ayushi, because that was a relay race. You passed it to me and I passed it to her. So I won't be, you know, very descriptive about mandala. Everybody has spoken about it. So for me, it is like a man ko dala. Okay. So I keep myself busy and I get a lot of peace while doing it. And then it is a increative art where you have to, keep yourself engaged into it. And like Ayushi did mention when she was training the mandala form, that if even there are any mistakes, how you can rectify those, which is even possible in your life, right? It's not only in the art forms, even in your life, how you can learn through those mistakes and how you can cover up. So thank you, Ayushi, for teaching all the art forms. And I really enjoyed myself. I did it almost after 20 years. Used to do it in the college and school days. So thank you for the same. And I would ask my daughter to continue with you, learning all the art forms. You mentioned that madam has given you this platform, right? But you are giving this platform to a lot of us to learn the art and to execute it. So thank you very much. I would just brief about what I have done here. I have done mandala, the first one, using just black pen. And the second one, I thought of initially using it only a black pen. However, I just started scribbling it again with the pink one. And then I thought, why not I give it a form of a sun? So I came up with this, mandala, the Surya mandala, you can say. And then Gond the painting. So I am just waiting for myself to go out and buy the watch machine so that I can convert this Gond the painting into a wall clock. And then again, a half mandala with a peacock. So yes, there were a lot of mistakes being done during learnings. But then yes, she has also taught us how you can cover up. And then this is again mandala. So whenever I get time, I just start, you know, putting some of the art form on the paper. So that is again a mandala. And then Ayushi, next one. Yeah, so I have always been teaching my daughter to come up with something you know, out of waste. So even in her school, they ask to do some craft activities. And basically, I teach her to use whatever we have available at home. So the dot mandala, what I have done on the round form is the cake ka base, which was just lying at my home. And I thought someday I'll use it for something. And this is how I have used it here. And then during Ganpati festival, I have done this dot mandala with Ganpati in the center. And the third form again was done while Ayushi was teaching us. So this has come up very differently. What she taught and what I did was completely different. It was bizarre for me, but then at the end, it came out well. And then I have also done some coasters using the MDF boards. So you can see it on the fourth and the fifth one are the coasters using MDF boards. So thank you, Creative Kalakar, and getting creativity out of us. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you so much, everyone. So now it's just my voice just to show the work that I did while teaching you all. So I just won't be really very descriptive about it because it's just the same that I've taught. So the first one is the Goan wall clock. The second one is the Pichwai art. Third one you can see is a Madhubani painting. And the next two are fluid arts that we did, fluid art workshop. Here again, there is one Madhubani. The black and white Madhubani, this is the same one, the colored one that we saw earlier, but this black and white I've just added onto it because I just love how the way it looks. And the last one here you can see is the Sora horse, and this is the complete mandala wall. While whatever mandala I've taught you, these are the ones out here. So this is my wall. And thanks to you, this wall is really coming up great. Thanks to you all. Because of you all, this wall, my wall is also, you know, updating itself, upgrading itself in mean course of time. So thank you so much, everyone, for attending this exhibition. Thank you so much. So much, and I'm so overwhelmed and this that I got to share my talent with almost, you know, 30 to 40 plus people in just the course of years time. And even in this course of time, like the last 6 months from lockdown, I have shared my talent with like 20 to 25 plus people because of Shivkala ma'am, that she gave me a platform, and that's where my work started. So Shivkala ma'am, can you just say tell how did you like the exhibition?
Beautifully done, and I really appreciate the effort that you've taken in molding your workshop, in including various topics, various art forms. And the best part that I saw in this exhibition is there is a mix of crowd. So right from a 7-year-old to a PhD holder, and you trying to get out that kalakar in them is a commendable thing. It's very important for a trainer or a teacher to bring that out from the student. It's very important. Where I am really happy to say that, you know, you've got that out very successfully. For the parents, I would say that first of all, congratulations that you took the step to letting yourself and your child be creative. The best part about the art forms, or rather art, is that there are no rules for it. You can go as wild as you can in any art form, in terms of colors, in terms of shapes, in colors of patterns. There is no rule about it. So please do not worry about being creative. Creativity does not have rule. The only rule creativity has is to be creative. Yes, it is a therapy. I like Ayushi, I have been living my passion for the past 8 years now after over 2 decades of corporate life. And trust me, it is a beautiful journey when you have something that you are passionate about and if it is fetching you money.
It is a
each one of you have taken, and I congratulate the tiny tots, how beautifully that they have come up with their creativity. You guys should keep doing this throughout on anything that you get. Now Hegde madam said that she took the cake base and she did it. You can be creative on anything in this world, whether it's wall, paper, clothing, wood, anything. Just let it out. It is a stress buster. So keep doing this, keep learning, keep experimenting. Do not stop yourself from experimenting. Mix two art forms. So Sora art and Varli are almost, they look very similar. Mix them. Add colors to Varli. Pichwai art is a very age-old art form and it is an expensive art form where gold and silver foils were used, and mainly it is used to depict Lord Krishna's life. Each of our art forms has got a mythological story behind it. The art forms from the Northeast, from Orissa or from the Northeast, have Jagannath ji, have Krishnas on them. Pattachitra or Madhubani has got Krishna's life stories, but depicted in a different way. Krishna is very important part character in a lot of our Indian art forms, but depicted in very, very different ways. So try to learn those things, that background behind it, and try to inculcate fusion. And Make in India is in trend now. Local to global is in trend now. Using Indian products, handmade products is in trend now. Ayushi, I will take your leave now. I have an ACT Talk session coming up at 5.
Sure.
I would kindly excuse me. Thank you, everyone.
So
all the
thank
best.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for being a part of our
session. Thank you, madam.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
So that's it. Thank you so much, everyone, for being a part of this. Soon.